Hello, I'm Alexander Popiac, Conservation Manager at Kopački Rit Nature Park, and I will present you something about my previous work on inventory of Plecoptera in Croatia that I was doing from 2014 to 2016. First, I would like to give some acknowledgements to the Ministry, now Ministry of Economy and Sustainable Development, and also Institute for Environment and Nature. They were clients and coordinators of the project, and also OICON, a private firm which was the lead partner of a consultant joint venture for two fauna inventory groups in whole Croatia. First, just a little introduction to Plecoptera, if you don't know them. They are aquatic insects. Their larvae live their life in water, and they're very sensitive to water pollution and habitat degradation. So they are widely used by the environmental monitoring agencies as bioindicators for assessing water quality. They call them as the most sensible to water destruction. Their terrestrial adults are also very important for proper species identification, mostly for these bigger species like here, Perla pallida from Cetina River. For these biggest species, you need to check their eggs on the scanning electron microscope to see the right species. Here is a picture of a Plecoptera life cycle. So on the left, female drops eggs into the water, into a stream or river, and then the larvae live from 1 to 3 years. From usually 1 year in the water and the benthos, and of some biggest species like Perla pallida from before, they live up to 3 years. After 3 years, they go out and they transform to adults. They are heavy metabolic insects, so they just larvae just get wings and started to fly a little bit around the water on riparian vegetation below bridges, and they mate to produce eggs and put eggs into the water. So for Croatia, only a few scientists have studied a little bit of Plecoptera for Croatia in the past. So Klapa, like mentioned, in the beginning of 20th century, 21 species for Croatia, then Pongrac 12, and after that Dragica Kačanski from Sarajevo Museum mentioned 5 species, and then Ignac Sivec from Slovenian Nature History Museum from Ljubljana. He published in 85 together 28 species for Croatia. And from May 2005, I started to work on my PhD thesis, and I was also colleagues connected me with Dr. Sivec from Ljubljana, and we started our joint intense studies on stoneflies in whole Croatia. Mostly at the beginning was Cetina River and Plitvice National Park for my thesis. Then we published many papers on Plecoptera in Croatia, and we increased the number of recorded Plecoptera species for Croatia from previous 28 to 50 species in these papers until 2011. During the last few years after this project, from 2014 to 16, we found some more species all around Croatia, and we were preparing the first checklist for Croatia for Plecoptera, but number was always changing higher and higher, 60, 70, 80, 90, or almost 100 species. So I was trying to wait for maybe 100 species to be round number to finally publish our checklist. We are estimating that there could be about 100, something more than 100 species in Croatia of Plecoptera, like similar in Slovenia and in Austria, and for Bosnia and Herzegovina is something near also 200. So Croatia should be something like that, very similar. With some recent field trips, also with Hungarian colleagues from the Hungarian Nature History Museum in Budapest, we had like one day field trip in the foothills of the Papuk Mountain, and we found four new species for Croatia in that one day field trip. So it was a sign like this eastern part of Croatia, it was really not studied almost at all. So we were waiting from our research, our latest inventory in whole Croatia, that in the east of Croatia there should be a lot more species that we knew before. So our project was called the NIP project. It was within EU Natura 2000 integration project. We had designated 179 square grid cells, 10 by 10 kilometers, and we started our field research on May 1st, 2014, and ended by the end of 2016. I think it was 22nd April 2016, and then by the end of 2016, we were identifying thousands and thousands of samples from whole Croatia. Each grid was mostly surveyed during three periods, like spring, autumn, and winter, because during the summer, during the hottest period, Lecoptera don't like hot air and hot water, so they live mostly during the colder weather, colder parts of the year, outside of the water, because larvae live in cold water, mostly cold and clear water, clean water too. So we surveyed during 260 days until the April 2016 on 406 localities inside 194 square grid cells, because we added some to check if there were some Lecoptera at least once in some additional square grid cells. And in Eastern Croatia, what is the point here about this presentation? We were considering Eastern Croatia like from here, from the line Pitomača, Grubišno Polje, Lipik, Okučani. We were looking for Lecoptera on 80 localities from 42 square grid cells, 10 by 10 kilometers, or 11 bigger square grid cells, 50 by 50 kilometers. This was the first really systematic study of this eastern part of Croatia for stoneflies, because before we think that mostly they are close to the border of Slovenia, because many Lecoptera species are alpine, pre-alpine species, and also there on the south, Plitvice Lakes National Park and southern Mediterranean rivers were rich with Lecoptera. So we're always thinking like there should not be a lot of Lecoptera in Pannonian lowlands in some slow rivers. But yeah, we are overlooking Papuk and Psunj mountains, which are really rich island of streams and springs in the middle of the lowland, Pannonian lowland. So these are the methods that we used, collecting adult insect specimens with sweep net from riparian vegetation and beating sheet method from the branches, then hand collecting larvae from the water course, then collecting with kick sweep sampling method, then collecting exuvia or adults beneath bridges or vegetation stones near water. Digital microphotography was used, and here's some part of the results. That in 154 10 by 10 square grid cells we recorded Lecoptera. And here inside this square grid cell, 10 by 10, this is the number of species that we recorded in that square grid cell. And at the end of the project, you can see that here in the Papuk Nature Park was the highest biodiversity with 25 species. There is one here, one grid cell with 25 species in this grid cell with five localities that were sampled. And after that is 23, here in the Plitvice Lakes National Park, is the second, the richest grid cell during this project. So as I showed you, it is the grid cell which includes five localities, Jankovac stream spring area, then down a little bit more down below the Jankovac upper reach of the Jankovac stream, then Šumečica stream in Slatinski Drenovac village, then Vojlovica middle part, also two more localities at Vojlovica. Vojlovica is one of the richest river in Croatia with special species of Plecoptera. And here quickly the sites and number of species which I mentioned. So this is all eastern Croatia, nice water courses, and here the summary results that almost 30,000 specimens we collected, about almost 6,000 were from eastern Croatia, and you can see also adults were about 8,000 from Croatia and 1,000 from eastern, and how many exuvi and larvae were collected and analyzed. We found almost all genera of Plecoptera in eastern Croatia. All seven families were found. 39 species was recorded from eastern Croatia, from 80 species that we identified from whole Croatia, so almost half. And 31 strictly protected species were recorded, and also almost more than half, 16, was recorded in eastern Croatia. And from four new species for Croatia, one was from three rivers on six localities in eastern Croatia. And here are some pictures of this. This is new species for Croatia, is from Vojlovica and Vočinka, and also some species that Matamea vitripenis, which we were thinking it's extinct in Croatia. We found some more localities, some more rivers where it was living normally. I'm over with my time, I see, so I will just quickly go to some localities with also some more important species, Perla burmeisteriana, which was found only larvae in Djedovica stream, a little upstream the Vočin village or town, and we also found it females with eggs in the beginning of the Drava River in Križevljan grad, in the beginning of the Drava River in Croatia. Xanthoperla apicalis is critically endangered and strictly protected species. We found it all from Mura and and the confluence of Mura and Drava up there in the northern Croatia, and here down the lowest locality was Drava near Belešće town, where we found this important species. So this is from Međimurje and then close Varaždin, and then this is the lowest location, this beach, sandy beach near Belešće, where was the lowest location for Xanthoperla apicalis. Some more important species we found here in Vojlovica and Vočinka for many times, and they are also new for Croatia, but we already found it together with Hungarians before, and we are preparing a paper which I think is still not published. But so I didn't mention them as new species, and they are in Europe, they are really rare, and in most countries they are extinct. So they are Agnatina elegantola, Rabdioptris acuminata, and Hamulata. So they are very abundant here in above Papuk Nature Park and below south of Papuk Nature Park. And here is Agnatina elegantola in Vojlovica River, all of phases of their life, so male and female, larvae, exuvia, everything you can find in Vojlovica River and also in Vočinka. So these are really important sites for rare endangered Plecoptera, so maybe also Papuk Nature Park could be a little bit more extended to the north to include these small rivers. So I already told you that we found 80 species by this field research, and with the analysis of literature and museum records in the first phase of the project, we found 105 species, but 19 of them were not really, were dubious. So together then with two phases of literature and museum records and with this field work, finally together 90 species of Plecoptera could be now considered reliable data for Croatia for now. And almost half of that is recorded in eastern Croatia before opposite to the before thinking of almost no Plecoptera could be in eastern Croatia. So also interesting thing that at the last part of the field research, we could not for many days of our research here in Baranja, in all along Danube and Karašica and Sava down part of Sava River, we couldn't find any Plecoptera. And then by the end of research, we found a lot of larvae of Nemura cinerea in Šarengrad village, in one small stream, Dobra Voda, was full of Plecoptera. So that is the easternmost finding of this species and general of Plecoptera in Croatia, and also is the only finding of Plecoptera in Croatia for some small direct tributary of large river like Danube. It's just 1 kilometer upstream in that little stream, before it goes into the Danube, you can find a lot of Plecoptera. So this is also very opposite to the previous thinking of no Plecoptera almost at all in the lowland eastern Croatia. So thank you, sorry for my overtime.